To develop as a photographer, you need to take a look at the work that you have done and try to review your own images. That way, you can start to find things that you find compelling about your images, but also find things that you might need to improve on. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Håkan, and in today's video, we're gonna take a look at my favorite photos from the last month, and we will do just that. We will take a look at the photos and we will try to review them and find things that I find compelling about my images, but also things that I can improve on. And hopefully, you can pick up some tips along the way that you can use in your own photography. So let's jump in and take a look at the first image. The first image is this one. It's from a place called Östra Langö. So I'm in a Facebook group about kayaking, and I've seen this place being mentioned a few times. So I became really interested in this place, and I thought it would be a great place to take a photograph. So I jumped in my car and drove to the car ferry that took me out to this island. And then I drove a really scenic narrow gravel road to reach the nature reserve. And then it was just a short walk to this place. So this is the most out of point of the nature reserve, and when I got there, I was really happy because it was really good weather, and it was just how I had imagined the image in my head. So I'm really happy with this image because I think this picture works. Because I use the stones as a leading line to the boat, which is the main subject. I wanted to show the boat in this grand landscape. I think the ocean is so big and we are so small, so that's what I want to show with this image. And I think using the stones as a leading line is a perfect way to get your attention to the boat. Then we also have like a triangle from the front stone to the right stones, and then to the island in the left corner. You have like a triangle, and then you have the boat kind of in the upper middle. So there you also have something that really points your eyes to the boat. I also like the tonal range in the luminosity between the really black points to the white points in the image. I think I get a good range of different luminosities in that grayscale. So yeah, I'm really pleased with this image, but not everything is good in this image, because if we zoom in on the image, we can see that the focus lies on the stone in the foreground, and when we start to look further back, you will see that we start to lose focus and the boat is not so much in focus anymore. Now, that is not a big problem if I just want to post it to Instagram, because the image will be so small. But if I want to do a big print, this will become a bigger problem. Now, the reason for this is I'm used to shooting Micro Four Thirds cameras, and there it's pretty easy to get everything in focus because of the small sensor. But this was the Ricoh GR III, and that camera has an APS-C sensor, and I didn't really count that in when I took the image. So that's the reason why the image is kind of out of focus in the background. Comment down below if you want to see another video where I go through how you can stack photos so the whole image becomes in focus, because that is what you want when you take an image like this. But overall, I really like this image, but there are things to be learned, of course. You will never be fully learned when it comes to photography, and I think that's the fun part. That's the first image. Okay, so the second image is this one, and it's a picture from a recent trip to Gatwick in Dalarna. And there they have, I think it was the world's longest wooden pier. I think it was 628 meters long. So one day me and my girlfriend took a walk out on the pier, and this is where I took this image. And I really think this is a good portrait photo. First of all, I really like the reflection on the pier, because that with the lines on the pier leads your eyes into the frame and up on the subject. And as same as the last image, I think the tonal range between the deepest blacks to the whitest whites is really good. And I also really like that the umbrella doesn't cross over to the mountains, because if you have different subjects crossing one another, it can be really distracting. So I really like that with this image. And I must say, I have a really hard time trying to find something that I don't like with this image. This image doesn't have the problem with not being in focus. This image is also taken with the Ricoh GR III. Maybe one thing I would have liked that would be if the subject could have more light in her face, but I tried to change the way she was standing, but I couldn't really get the light the way I wanted. But overall, I'm happy with this image. I think it's a good portrait. So that's the two favorite images from the last month. So if you have liked this video, please give it a thumbs up, and also consider subscribing to my channel, because that would mean a lot to me. And also comment down below your thoughts. I always enjoy reading and answering your questions. So until next time, bye.